Good morning and welcome to the Green Valley Parkinson's Support Group exercise class. I hope you had a wonderful weekend, and we're going to have a beautiful week here in Arizona. A little warm, but nonetheless gorgeous. So if you're joining us for the first time, you're going to need a chair without arms, some light hand weights, a tennis ball, a larger ball, and today we'll be using a pipe, a PVC pipe. So maybe a broom handle or an umbrella, a cane, yeah, something like that. So great, we'll get started. The first thing you want to do is sit forward in the chair. Sit away from the back, concentrating on posture. Your feet flat on the floor, some space behind you. Take a deep breath through the nose. And let it out slowly through the mouth. Again. Exhale. And drop the chin to the chest. Stretch. And then lift the head. Looking forward, tilt it. Yeah. And center. And to the other side. Center. This time we're going to look up. The mouth opens just slightly. And straight down, pressing the shoulders down. Now circle the head. And let's go the other way. Again, that chin to the chest. Sit tall, but raise the head and look up. And center. And now we're going to turn to look over one shoulder. Drop the chin and nod at your neighbor, Kurt. Yeah, perfect. And to the other side and nod at your neighbor, Nancy. Good. And forward. Shoulders, roll them. And reverse it. Good. And lift them up and down and up and down. Two more. Up high. Last one. Job. Extend the arms. So shoulders now relaxed. Fingers, move them. And then extend the fingers out, tapping finger to thumb. Yeah. That is nice music. I like it. Spread the fingers out and think of scratching and count. One, two, as loud as you get. Three, thank you. Four, last one. Five, make a fist and squeeze and out. Two, it's hard. Four, squeeze and hold. Two, three, four, five. Now the shoulders relax, the fingers extend and roll the wrist. Two, three, four, five. Reverse it, just isolating that wrist. Three, two, one, and there. We're gonna rotate the arms slightly. Palms face center as we cross those arms. Good. And then open wide, flip it. Again, cross in front. Yeah. And flip it again. Place the other one in on top. Good. And flip it. Perfect. And they come down, the hands rest on the chair for a side stretch. So you're looking forward, and then you want to turn to look down at the floor. Again, out, and same thing on this side. Big stretch. Perfect. And then twist and look and open, bringing them back to this position. Twist the upper torso and to the other side and center. Those hands rest on the chair for the next one. Shift the weight. The opposite hip is up and lift it high. Good. Two and three. Yes. And four. And last one. Five. And so we're back into this position. You still have space behind you. Let's walk a little bit. The arms just do whatever. Oops, that was just the pole. No problem. Yeah. Breathe.
Six.
Yeah. Seven.
Eight.
Nine. Good job. Now bring it back down. And we stop in that position right there. We're going to reach out and grab those free weights now. And when you make a decision to buy some, make sure that they're challenging your muscles, but they're not compromising your position. In other words, don't pick out something too heavy. So wrap them. 50, 60 pounds. Yeah, a little bit too much. I'm impressed, though. So we're going to start with a bicep curl. So they come up a couple inches off your thigh. Look forward as you curl to the shoulder and down. Two. Yeah. Three. Four. Five. Good. Six, sitting tall. Seven, eight, nine, 10. And that's the first set. So stretch a little bit. Don't forget to breathe. Holding your breath does no good. So again, wrap it, lift them up and curl. One, two, thank you. Three, four, five, six, seven, 8, 9, 10. Keep them in your hands, drop the arms to the side. And we're gonna sit real tall as we rotate the shoulders forward. Good. And then back, stretching the chest, pinching those shoulder blades together. And then this neutral position, lift one, tuck. And this is a lateral side stretch. So you wanna look forward, trying to find the floor. There it is, good. Come up. Change to the other side. Lift one and drop the other. Perfect. And down. And we're going to get rid of one. Place it on the floor underneath your chair. And we're going to go right into an overhead extension. So wrap the fingers, extend the arms, the shoulders, they're down, and the weight drops to the back. Elbows high, chin off your chest, and then those arms up, down, two, three, can't get him, four, five, six, perfect, seven, eight, nine, 10, good job, and down, breathe. All right, ready? Second set, wrap them, straight up, relax the shoulders, it drops to the back, and it's up, down, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, you got it, 9, 10, and down. Place this one with its friend underneath the chair and out of your way as you bring your feet and your knees together. A little adjustment, but try to stay away from the back, the arms crossed. Oops. And extend and lift. And we're gonna flex and point, flex and point. Three, four, five, good. Six, seven, eight, 9, 10. Flex those feet, heels touch, toes out for five, two, three, four, five, toes touch, heels out. Feels weird, doesn't it? Yeah. Three, four, five. And they come down, uncross, separate the feet back into this position as we scoot forward a little bit, extending one leg. The arms are out, the fingers spread apart. Twist, reach for it, opposite hand, and the focus is on the foot as the other arm is reaching behind you and up for the ceiling. Good. And then come up, same arm as leg, reach for it and hold. Two, three, four, five, and those arms come down, the leg comes in, the other extends, opposite, arm to leg, reach and hold. Two, three, four, five, good job. And up, and again, looking at the foot, reach and hold. Two, three, four, five, super, and down. And we're gonna take it wide. We're still out, we've got some of that leg off of the seat. Take it in a wider position within your range. So kind of shift your weight from side to side. You want to try to keep those knees directly over your feet. And if it's not happening, then bring them in a little bit. Find what your range of motion is, flexibility. So here, one hand on the inside for support, this straight up. Twist and look up as you spread the fingers, reaching for the ceiling. The other one is on the inside of the calf, reaching for your ankle or the floor. Great job, and come up. Try it to the other side. Stretch and hold. two, three, four, five. Perfect. They drop down, walk them in, heel, toe, heel, toe, heel, toe. Feet touch and the knees may be together, sitting tall, those arms crossed. Transfer the weight forward, reaching from your hips so it's a flat back. As you stretch, placing that weight on the outside of the foot, bring it together and come up. Good job. Transfer the weight and stretch. And come up, sitting tall. We're going to uncross them and find that place that we started in again. Reaching for both weights, we're going to do some overheads. So wrap the fingers, the weights brought to the shoulder, and we're going to rotate them out and extend them to the side, straight up. So if you're looking at these, the thumb is close to your face, the fingers are on top, palms facing. So if it's here, turn it around. So straight up, stretch, pull it down and back. Yes, up, down and back. Perfect. Three, pull them down. Four, you got it. Five, six, down and back. Seven, yes. Eight, down and back. Nine, 10, yes. Take a break. That's the first set of 10. So stretch a little bit and breathe. We're gonna sit tall again to the shoulder, out and beyond. So lift them up and they touch at the top. Let me hear it. You've got metal. Aha, yes. Two, love that sound. Three, four, shout it out. Five, I don't hear you. Six, seven, good. Eight, nine, last one, 10. Great job, and we're done. Place them on the floor. Great job. All right, we're gonna do some more stretches. And one of my favorite, if Charlie's watching from Indiana, this one's for you. So turn, you're sitting at an angle now with that front chair leg in between your feet. Your feet are still about hip-width apart. The hand close to the frame, hold on. The outside arm and leg extends in opposite directions. Spread the fingers. Pretend to grab something and pull it towards your chest. Rounding the back, tucking the chin. And again, stretch it out. Good, Nancy. Reach for it. Pull it in. Round it up. Good. And come up. And we've got the other side. So turn. Sitting tall, hold on, and reach, 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 good. Pull it and round it up. Nice, reach for that and pull it in. Perfect. And we're back into this position, facing forward. All right, remember the pole? Now it's the time, yours is trying to escape. All right, I don't know. It's been a while. I'm sorry you're not here to enjoy the whole thing. Boom. There are about 37 inches, I think, and it's a PVC pipe, so we're going to use that today. Starting with a stretch, don't grab it. This is just going to rest between your thumb and your index finger. And your feet are back into a starting position. Extend the arms. And my hands are going to be out toward the very edge. This is a lateral stretch. So if you hold on to it, what happens is you stretch to the side and this arm pulls the other one up. I don't want that. I want us to work on our core. So it's to the side, looking forward, and then lift it up. Now you feel it, right? That's waist management at its very best. Two, and all the way up. Do you feel that? Uh-huh. Oh, good. Three, and up, and stretch. Two more. Four, and up, all the way to the side. Nice. And last one, stretch, and stretch. Perfect. And then straight up as you kind of hold on to it now, and it's going to be about chest height. right there. And now your focus should be right in the middle of that. As you twist the upper body to the side, and this back arm now gets to pull the front arm and hold. 2, 3, 4, 5. Looking just at the center of the pole. Take it to the other side. Good. And pull. 2, 3, 4, 5. Great job. Yeah, I love this pole. You can do a lot of things with it. All right, your arms extended out, and we're just going to transfer that. Don't place it, but just a little toss. You want to be able to see the pole, so if you hold it too close, that's not going to work. And then separate your hands a little bit more, and then bring them real close, back and forth, and see if you can't close your eyes. And toss that from one hand to the other, knowing just when to let go and when to hold on to it. Perfect. All right. Again, we're holding it straight out. Sitting tall in the chair, roll the wrist and lift and roll. Good. Stretch it. One more. There. All right. And this next one, I'm going to have to turn a little bit. Yeah, right there. Now, as you see, sitting upright, shoulders over hips, but we want to be out here a little bit because the worst thing could happen is that your hands slip and that happens. So I don't want that to hit you. So not too close. You want to be out a bit and make sure that it's on the floor. Pretty stable. And you're going to walk your hands down. Walk your hands as far as you can. You're going to round the back. As you tuck the chin, try to get down as far as you can, maybe all the way down to the floor, and hold. And then walk back up, stacking your hands one on top of the other. Lengthening the spine as you go. Good. All the way up. Yeah, perfect. Good stretch. Okay, we're going to face forward again, placing this on the floor. Stay. All right, our arms drop to the side, and if you feel like you need to hold on, use it, but otherwise they're here. And we're going to place both feet on top, roll it back and forth. Back and forth. And you'll get a better feel without shoes and socks. Same thing that we do with the ball. Yeah. A lot of things. You can sword fight. You can make like musical. Don't try anything right now. Back and forth. Good. Yeah, massage your feet. So just some ideas that you can do for at home. And we're done with this. The best thing I think is just to place it underneath your chair so it feels the back of that. Right like so. All right. We're going to do a chair lift right now. So the weights can be down there, the hands braced on the chair, and this is upper body strength. And it's really important because if you fall, you're going to need that upper body strength. And we're all going to need to know how to do that, get off the floor. So here, some weight forward and lift up. Good. All the way off that seat. Perfect. 3. Good. 4. 5 more, 6, good, 7, 8, 9, 10, and down. Feet together, knees touching if they can, and forward a couple more inches. Hold on, sit tall in the chair, lean back a little bit, the knees come to the chest and down. It's up, 2, I don't hear it, 3, all right, 4, 5, good, 6, 7, keep going, 8, 9, 10, and down. Separate them and scoot back as we move right into toe touches. So sitting tall, it's up, and 2, and good, 3, and 4, and you got it, 5, and 6, and 7, and 8, and 9, and 10, and whew, catch your breath, but reach down, grab those weights, and place them pretty close to the edge. I know it's one of those things that you think, oh, it's going to fall, so I better tuck my thumb underneath, but try not to. Try to have the whole hand rest on those free weights. So sit tall. We're going to lift it, extend it, bend, and touch. It's up, out, in, and touch. Three, out, in. Good job. Two more.
Four.
And one more.
Five.
Bring it back. The weight just shifts to the other side. The focus should be forward as you lift, extend, bend, and touch. Two, out, and touch. Three, out, and touch. Four, touch. Last one, five, and touch. We are done with those, so place them on the floor. And because we had the pole, we're not going to do all the exercises we normally do with that tennis ball, but we are going to do some. So sit tall, roll it between your hands. Be aware of your posture. Are you still sitting upright in the chair? Yeah. Stretch the fingers and work that in between. Good. And there, and there. All right. With that sitting just on a soft fist, the other hand resting on your thigh, close your eyes. Try to extend that arm out from the chest and just hold it there. Keeping your eyes closed, try to place it carefully in the other hand. Same thing with the arm extended. Open your eyes, good. And that ball on the floor. We use the pole a little bit to roll back and forth, but let's use the ball, push down on it and roll back and forth. Quick, quick release. Good job. Nancy, you have a sandal stencil on your foot now. It's the suntan. Let's make sure we do both feet. So push down and roll back and forth. All right. Yeah, stimulate the nerve endings on the bottom of your feet. That helps you with balance. So we're going to grab that and we're going to scoot back into the chair, making sure that our feet are still in a wide position. Pull them back. And press, like if your hand is back there, you want to press into the back of the chair. Arch the back, press. Stretch the chest, lifts a little bit, and press again. And continue to press hard against the back of the chair. Legs out and up, circle. Yeah, rotating the ankles. Beautiful. And the other way, yes, three, two, one. The feet, they hit the floor. They get pulled back. Sit tall, shifting the weight from right to left as you walk forward out to the very edge of that chair and the feet on the floor. Arms overhead. This is some core work, so lean back and come up. Yes, lean back and sit tall. Three. Mondays are always like this, aren't they? Four. They're hard. Go back and hold. One, two, three, four, five. Again, stack it and place the hands on your thighs as you transfer the... Look down at that beautiful floor. It's a flat back you should have. You're going to go up on the ball of the foot, down on the heels, up, up, down, down, working the feet. Press into that floor. One more. Good. And then the heels up and down, up and down, up and down. Ready for a sit to stand. Where's that pole? Nose over toes. So if my feet were out here, I couldn't get up. They need to be back a bit and all of this upper body weight forward as you shift. Come up. Good. Bend and back into it. The arms to the side, shift and up, and bend and down. Overhead, shift and up. Two more. Straight out, shift the weight, good. And cross, shift the weight, and come up, perfect. Back into the chair, catch your breath. Right there. All right, elbows out. This is a seated crunch warm-up, so twist side to side. Work in that waistline again as you twist knee to opposite elbow and up. Two and lift. Three and up. Good. Four and up. Five. Keep going. Six. Seven. Eight. Nine. 10. Super. All right. The big ball. All right. How big? I don't know. 9 or 11 inches, something like that. Again, sit forward in the chair. You've got some space behind you. The ball. We're almost twins. All right. It drops down. Yeah. Extend. Transfer the weight forward. Don't lower the arms, but reach out instead, and then try to place the head in between those arms and hold. Two, three, four, five. Come up slowly, the arms still extending forward. Pull away, tucking the chin to the chest, round the back. And again, sit tall, the arms overhead, lean back slightly. Good job. And up, track it this time. Just like we did with the pole, and center, and to the other side, twisting that spine, good, and center. And now, place it underneath one arm, let that come down over it. This hand is here, squeeze hard as you can, and relax, again, squeeze. And relax. Same thing on this side. So you're working on posture. It's that isometric thing again as you squeeze. And relax. And one more. Squeeze. Good job. And relax. You should have this space right in here in that inner thigh area. We're going to do the same thing. So place it not by the knee but on the inside. The hands on top, the feet now close together. Pull up and squeeze. Feeling this in your hip. Yeah, right in here. You start to quiver a little bit, right? Yeah, or a lot, mine. And relax. And again, squeeze hard. Good job. And relax. Separate the feet and this ball between them on the floor as you close in on it. Find a different spot. Uh-oh. Technical. Hold on just a moment. We're gonna. There we go. All right. Hold on to that ball. The arms drop to the side. Use the chair legs if you need to, but if not, let them drop to the side and it's up down. A lot of core work today, right? Three, four, five, because I love you. Six, seven, eight, nine, 10. And then bring it in, hold on to the ball, bring it in. We're gonna get out of the chair and we're gonna use this today. So keep the weights underneath, shift the weight forward, nose over toes, and come on up. I'm just gonna put that. And if that is in your way, let's just pick it up and we'll put it, maybe. You good? Yeah. Is that gonna bother you, Nancy? Okay. Some ankle raises. Exactly, if I wasn't gonna say that. All right, behind the chair. Too close, not good. Too far away, you're reaching for it. So find that place that you can just barely touch it if you need it. Shift the weight onto the ball of the foot and down. So ankle strength. Three, four, good. Five, six, seven, eight, Hold on 10. Focus forward, go up and hold. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Keep going. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And down. The weight shifts to the heel. Toes up for 10. 2, 3. Lift them high. 4. Good. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And down. Shake it out a little bit. Since we're standing in this position, we'll start with lateral leg lifts, and then we'll move to back and forward. So again, placement is important. Your feet right underneath you. The weight shifts to one side. Soft knee. The focus. Find something. You've got a good quilt to look at. Find something to look at. And this is going to go out to the side, not too high. You end up counterbalancing. So pretend there's a wall right there and it's up, down. Good. 2. You've got it. 3, 4. Feel it in the hip. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Place it wide. The weight shifts. Focus forward as you lift and lower. 2, 3. Good. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and down. And I'm going to turn just a little bit. We're going to still be behind the chair, and we're going to be able to kick back there. So it's a straight leg. Now think of that wall that was to the side is right in front of you. So too far forward, yes, you can lift it higher, but then you're not standing tall. So you'll feel this in your glutes, hamstrings, lower back. It's up, down. 2, do you? 3, good. 4, 5, 6, 7, beautiful. 8, great job. 9, 10, bend the front knee and stretch. That's our reward. Yes, perfect. And come up, bring it forward, bring it wide, shift the weight, extend, straight leg, don't bend the knee, lift it up. 2, 3, 4, 5, good. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, bend and sit. Oh yeah, yeah, good. And come up, and we're gonna stand to the side. Doesn't matter what side, we'll do them both. So make sure that that weight is on the inside leg, the one close to your chair. Hold on, extend, straight leg. Same rule applies, not too high. You want the shoulders over hips, so it's up, down, perfect. 2, 3, okay, 4, sorry, 5, too much talking, 6, 7, 8, yeah, 9, 10. And bring it back to the other side. I like to have the standing leg close to what we might hold on to. So here, the weight shifts, hand here, focus, eyes off the floor, lift it up, bring it back. 2, good, 3, 4, 5, 6, working from the hip, 7, 8, 9, 10, and down. Super job. Turn down just a little bit. Now we're going to use the ball. Now we're going to come back to that first position. So this is more balance work. Your feet are going to stand in, Nancy, I don't know why, but I'm getting nervous with that pole.
Just push it.
Okay, you sure? Ah, she signed the waiver. It's good. All right. Feet in a staggered position. We call it a split step. So just take a normal step forward with the outside foot. Yeah, right like that. And the arms extended. And they're away from your chest. Don't lock the elbows, but you should be able to go up on your toes a little bit. And if you need to use the chair, then the outside arm holds the ball and the other one is on the chair. But you want to find center. And arms out, we're going to look away from that as you maybe look towards your chair and over that shoulder. Good. Center. Now to the other side, turning just the head. Perfect. And center. And up slightly. and straight down, which is always the easiest because that's what we do most of the time is look down. Good job. Let's try that to the other side. Stagger, that's called a split step. Outside foot takes a step forward. Find center, all right? Outside arm extends or both. Look toward the chair, just the head turns. Good. Center and away from the chair. Center and up. And down. Beautiful. All right. And I don't know why I just go back to the first side. You don't have to. You can stay there if you want to. And we're going to stand beside our chair in a position that's comfortable for you. Okay? So hopefully it's not ever this one where your feet are really close together. And that's not a very stable position. So here. And we're just going to transfer that ball from side to side. Yeah. No big deal. Right? Yeah. And if you're like me, look how close this ball is. Let's extend it out just a little bit. All right. Now hold on to it with both hands and just walk in place. More like a march, I guess, because we don't really walk like that, but a march. Good. And now stop and look. And look. And look. And look. Good. We're going to put all of those together. Yes, we are. We're going to start with a walk. The arms a little extended. Okay. Transfer the ball hand to hand. Good. Look over one shoulder. The hardest part is just hanging out by your chair. Usually I want to walk away from it. Good. Look to the other side. Perfect. Look up slightly. And down. Beautiful. Keep marching. We're going to have that ball away and just let it drop. Pick it up. Drop and pick it up. Keep marching as you bounce and catch. Bounce and catch. Good. I'm usually not one big on multiple tasking because you end up doing nothing good. They're all kind of mediocre. But this is a good practice for balance. All right. Now, back into, we were getting a little cardio too. So we keep marching, arms extended away from your chest. Just toss it a few inches off your fingertips. Yeah, so you can see it. Oh, I was afraid of that. Where are you when I need you? All right. Yeah, too high, you end up going back. So it's just there. Just so you can see it. Good. Keep marching. We're going to see if we can get a clap in between that. So, good. Catch it and just get back into it. Perfect. Yeah. Yeah, too high, you end up kind of going backwards. So you want to be able to just get it right in front. Very nice. And keep marching. We haven't stopped. We're going to bounce it and catch it. On the floor and catch. Good. Perfect. All right. I'm a little out of breath too. Super. All right, we take that and we're going to put it down there. And we are going to do some real cardio. So if you're at home, I hope you're somewhere where the surface is flat and there are not things around that you might walk into or hurt yourself. So quickly, I'm going to put something on, and it's about 2 minutes, and we're going to get some cardio.
Well, it's one for the money, two for the show. Three to get ready now, go cat, go, but don't you step on my blue suede shoe. Well, you can do anything, but thank you for my blue suede shoe. Well, Well, you can knock me down, step in my face, slander my name all over the place. Well, do anything that you wanna do, but no, honey, lay off your little shoes and don't you step on my blue suede shoes. Well, you can do anything, but lay over my blue suede shoes. Let's go.
Power walk. Good job.
Well, it's a one for the money, two for the show, three to get ready now. Go, go, go.
Aww. Woohoo. Okay. Back into the chair. Sip of water always. All right. A little out of breath, I do hope. Yeah. Find that starting place that you have space behind you. Grab a weight. And you thought we were done. We're almost there. Wrap the fingers straight up. The shoulders, they're relaxed. As you reach with a flat back, drop those arms between your feet, flat back, and up. Nine more. Two. Yes. Three. Up. Four. Try not to use the momentum. Five. Well, that takes all the fun out of it. Six. And up. Seven. Sitting tall. Eight. Nine, 10. Yes, and up. Great job. Whew. Okay. This is what you've been waiting for. The end, the cool down. So sit tall. Again, your feet apart. Take a deep breath. Exhale slowly. Inhale. Exhale. One more. And out. Drop the chin to the chest. And lift the head. Listen. Center and up. And center and to the other shoulder. Again, chin to the chest. Slowly circle. And the other way. Drop it forward and lift it up, allowing the mouth to open. Again, chin to the chest and center. The shoulders forward, up, back, and down. Circle. And the other way. All the way up. Flip them. Let them rest on your shoulders. Those elbows touch and stretch. And touch and stretch. Good job. One more. Stretch it back. Pull it in and unfold. Rotate the arm and the shoulder. Pretending to turn a doorknob. There. You got it. Cross. And stretch. Yes. Place the other arm on top. Give yourself a hug. and stretch. You ready? A-E-I-O. One more time. A-E-I-O. Great job. Go out and enjoy your day, and I'll see you on Wednesday.